One day, Jeremy fell asleep during his class, but with his lecture alarm, hello everyone, here comes another tutorial. The components that we need are CD Uno, half breadboard, a buzzer, the tube sensor module, NPN2222 transistor, 2.2K ohm resistor, male to male jumper wires, male to female jumper wires, and USB cables. Here comes the hero. First, connect the pins on the module with male to female jumper wires. There are three pins that we will be using. The first one is the power pin, the ground pin, and lastly the digital pin, which will give out digital output to the CD Uno. Now, connect the power pin to the positive terminal of the breadboard, while the ground pin is connected to the negative pin of the breadboard. The digital pin is connected to pin 2 digital of the CD Uno. Use male to male jumper wires to connect the positive terminal to the power supply of the CD Uno, and another one to connect to the ground. This CD Uno will supply 5 volt power supply. Now, let's connect the buzzer. Place the flat side of the transistor onto your breadboard. Then, the furthest right will be the collector pin, the middle will be the base, whilst the furthest left is the emitter. Use a 2.2 kilo ohm resistor to connect to the CD Uno at the base pin. This is to prevent current sinking. The buzzer will be using pin 3 of the CD Uno. The buzzer has terminals. The red one represents the positive terminal, while the black one represents the negative terminal. Connect the red one to the power supply, while the black one to the collector pin of the transistor. Connect the emitter to ground. The setup is complete. Now, let's have a look at the program. I use liquidcrystal.h and wire.h library. If you don't have this library, you can download them online. These are the characters that will be displayed on the LCD. Notice that there are some spaces on the LCD to clear the LCD. Now, let's look at two cases. The cases where the tilt model is high and the tilt model is low. If the tilt model is high, the buzzer turns on, whereby it senses a tilt. Now let's compile and upload the program. Once I tilt, the buzzer turns on and wakes the user. Sometimes, the tilt sensor module may not be sensitive. You can adjust its sensitivity by adjusting its potentiometer. Now, now you don't have to worry about falling asleep again. Thank you for watching. Bye!